is Carol Silver Elliott. I'm president and CEO of the Jewish Home Family, which is the organization that's the parent of the Jewish Home at Rockley, Jewish Home Assisted Living, and Jewish Home at Home, our home and community-based services, and the Jewish Home Foundation. We are finishing tonight the celebration of our centennial year. 100 years is a remarkable achievement, and our celebration has really been focused on not necessarily recognizing the past, but really focusing on the future. What comes next? What's the future of aging services? What's the future of healthcare? So to end our program with a topic like this is absolutely fitting, and we are delighted that all of you are here tonight to share this evening with us, because I know it's going to be one that is not only enlightening and educational, but also incredibly thought-provoking. We are delighted to partner tonight with our friends at Englewood Hospital and Medical Center, and also the friends of Bar-Ilan University. It truly does take a village to make things like this happen, and tonight's a perfect example of it. So at this point, I would like to introduce you to Warren Geller, who is the president and CEO of Englewood Hospital and Medical Center.
Thank you, Carol. Congratulations on that 100-year milestone. We are very proud to be here this evening with our partners and friends from the Jewish Home Family and the American Friends of Bar-Ilan University for putting on a program with such a compelling, important topic. I had a meeting today of our medical staff. We also had an awards ceremony in here today where we were discussing and celebrating our quality awards. And believe me, there were not this many people in the seats. I should have come up with a better topic, maybe about this could happen to you if our quality wasn't this good. Come listen. It really is a topic that's near and dear to all of our hearts, and to have a world expert here like Dr. Eitan Okun to come in here with such groundbreaking research at an early age and something that is affecting this community a great deal, because here in Bergen County and the surrounding areas, we're not growing rapidly, but we're aging more rapidly than the rest of the United States. So this community in particular, this is a very important topic. We are celebrating throughout this year our 125th anniversary, and actually, thank you. My chief of staff, Liza Kind, spent the day in Washington and missed our awards ceremony because she was accepting an award on our behalf. For the second consecutive year, we were just named one of 100 America's top hospitals for patient safety. It really is a testament for the great medical staff and support staff that we have working as one here at the medical center. I'd now like to introduce Mr. Howard Sharish, who's the National Director of Development of the American Friends of Bar-Ilan University. Howard, if you can come up, thank you.
Thank you, Warren. Congratulations are due all around to Englewood Hospital Medical Center being one of the top 100 hospitals. And of course, to our other partner, Jewish Home Family, on its 100th anniversary, mazel tov to you as well. Let me share with you a snapshot of Bar-Ilan University. While it is one of Israel's largest universities, it has 33,000 students enrolled, and it's celebrating its 60th anniversary. It's not as well known as some of other Israel universities are. So here's just a snapshot of what it's like. Bar-Ilan prides itself on having a diverse student body, whether it be Jewish, Arab, Christian, Druze, whether students have a left of center, center, or right of center political orientation, whether they are observant or non-observant, they all come together on one campus. Diverse backgrounds, diverse views, but all come together to share values. As our president is fond of saying, we all have different backgrounds and options, but we share one heart in being in Israel together. Bar-Ilan distinguishes itself by having many centers of excellence, including nanotechnology, engineering, law, Torah scholarship, and recently, we opened, just 4 years ago, Israel's fifth medical school. To many people's surprise, Israel has a current shortage of doctors. The great population of physicians arrived in the 70s and 80s out of the former USSR, FSU, and now they're of retirement age. And until Bar-Ilan opened its school, only 500 physicians were graduated a year. Certainly not enough for the population. Bar-Ilan is now adding physicians to the pipeline. But by opening the medical school in Tzfat, which is in the northern region of Israel, it is now giving accessibility to treatment and adding research to the northern perimeter, the northern periphery, a place where past studies said that if you live there, your life expectancy was less than living in the center because obviously you did have access to treatment and top research. Bar-Ilan is not an ivory tower university. It firmly believes in giving back. That's why we think that the reason that most students who have finished their service in the military, use their IDF scholarships at Bar-Ilan, and most officers of the Israeli IDF graduate from Bar-Ilan. We are proud that Bar-Ilan has this winning combination, and we invite you to learn more about us. There's literature in the back, and if you're planning a visit to Israel, consider coming to our campus in Ramat Gan, and call me. I'll help you plan it. So we welcome you, and we're delighted to be partners. I want to mention, how did this program develop? Well, last March, Melanie Cohn read the Jewish Standard, and hi, Jamie, and saw an ad from American Friends of Bar-Ilan University that Eitan Okun was featured in. She read it and said, Alzheimer's, preventing memory decline. That would be something that Jewish Home Family would like to add to its program. We had a brief conversation. We immediately connected and began the planning, and then turned to Englewood Hospital and Medical Center to be our third partner. And as we all know from the dinner outside in this beautiful auditorium, it was the perfect place to bring us all together. I want to take a moment to thank Melanie, because she has been the steward of this program, and I want to give you some advice. If you want something done, and you want it done right, call Melanie Cohn. She's a pure joy to work with, and she does it with competency and graciousness. We all thank you, Melanie. I also want to mention our other partners for this evening, including Ezra Halevi, who's Director of Marketing and Community Relations at Jewish Home Family, and Lisa Segelbacher. You probably get an extra round of applause. The food was great, Lisa, so thank you. From Englewood Hospital and Medical Center team, we had Michael Petrowitz, who is the Senior Vice President, Alicia Park, Vice President for Communications, Phyllis Brown Edwards, Director of Community Outreach, and Lori Vila, Special Events Coordinator, and from Bar-Ilan University, American Friends, Alan Grossman, thank you. Alan's the Director of Marketing and Communications. Thank you all, dear colleagues. Now I have the privilege. Yes, it's appropriate. And I'm sure you'll clap even harder after the program's done. I have the privilege of introducing our keynote speaker, Dr. Eitan Okun. Dr. Okun is the poster boy for Bar-Ilan University. I say boy because everyone comments he's so young. He really is. He got his undergraduate and master's and PhD from Bar-Ilan. He went to the National Institute of Health from 2007 to 2011, where he was in the National Laboratory on Aging, and in 2011 came back to Bar-Ilan as a staff researcher and now chief researcher at the university. His team, as you've read in the backup and you'll see in Friday's Jewish Standard, concentrates on finding molecular mechanisms that delay aging and memory decline in Parkinson's and in Alzheimer's disease. I got a preview of tonight's program, and we're in for a treat. Topic, as you see over here, is the future of treating memory decline, and everyone wants to know about that vaccine. I joke there's a table outside where we'll be giving the shots. Not yet. Not yet. One final thing. I wanted to do our due diligence in inviting Dr. Okun to be here. So we spoke to the Vice President of Research and Development at Bar-Ilan University, himself an inventor, former head of our nanotechnology department. We asked him one question: is he a star? The answer came back in capital letters, yes. Now you will see for yourself. Dr. Okun.
Okay. After all these exaggerations, I would like to thank you for coming in this weather. I know it's not easy in the rain. Okay. Really, the story of Alzheimer's is the story of our living through a childhood all the way through aging in a situation in which we constantly look forward and we want to age gracefully. Okay, want to age, get to the after pension, to the stage in which we can get all the fruits. Okay, we've grown, grandchildren,